Applause, you're just waiting for applause, aren't you? Applause, my man. Yeah. Alright, guys, you're gonna love this super fun Sunday night.
So I'm John, I'm a 1.5 liner comedian, which is funny because that's the thing about minimalist humour, you either get it. Just want to see who's in the room. Do we have any gay people in the room tonight? Thanks for coming out. Have any premature ejaculators in the house tonight? Thanks for coming. A bit about me, I'm dyslexic, and that depressed me so much once I tried to slit my waist. It gets worse. I have an aborted cousin. Once removed. Another cousin died when he was a little boy in his first week of school. When we went to the funeral, we were shocked to find the coffin he'd been placed in was way too big for him. His mother, somewhat in denial, leaned into us and said, "Oh, don't worry, he'll grow into it." Comedy isn't a full-time thing for me. I have a few other jobs. At the moment, I clean up after horses, which isn't very glamorous work, but it's stable work. I'd like to be a plumber. That's the pipe dream. I tried that same joke with carpentry, but there's no way it would work. And I used to be a psychic. Now, I wasn't the best psychic you'd ever seen, but I wasn't the worst psychic you'd ever seen, so I suppose I was a medium. I've written a couple of books. It's called Everything You Ever Wanted to Know About Over-Exaggeration, and much, 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 much more. The other book is called Everything You Ever Wanted to Know About Social Anxiety, But You Were Too Afraid to Ask. Here's a piece of advice. Every bed is a pull-out bed when you don't have a condom. I also paint a lot of self-portraits, which worries my parents because I'm constantly wandering around the house looking for somewhere to hang myself. I tell you what, worse. That's what I do. I do one-liners and gags and puns, and I break my jokes down into three different categories, three different tiers. Tier one is like the Christmas cracker kind of humor. Dad jokes, really inoffensive, nobody gets upset. So, for example, I have a very musical background. I come from a long line of conga dancers. My parents were in a band, but I was raised on a farm, so the first instrument I learned to play was the electric fence. 37, 38, 39, 41. 40. Sorry, counting was never my forte. They told me I couldn't write jokes about headache tablets. Well, I'd be proofing them wrong. Apparently they're now selling minty cigarettes. Apparently they sell minty cigarettes now. Phew, menthol. And I recently moved into a new apartment. In the city centre. And as I was settling in, I looked out the window to see that I could see right across the way into my neighbour's apartment. And I noticed that my neighbour would stand in this room alone in his apartment a couple of times a day, and he would do something really strange. He would do this. Totally on his own, a couple of times a day for at least 5 minutes. And I know a lot of people here are making judgments and saying he was probably crazy, he was probably a bit nuts, but I decided this is my new neighbour, I'm going to get to know him and find out why he's the way he is. And I learned a lot. The most important thing I learned is that just sometimes it's just very difficult to see. Dental floss at a distance. That's tier one. Tier two of my jokes is where you start to introduce people and cultures and conditions, and that runs the risk of being a bit offensive because it's a bit edgier. I think it makes them funnier. Where are the Irish people in the room? When I was in my fourth year of secondary school, I began to grow my hair long. I wore a girl's uniform and went to class wearing makeup, and I was told I was taking transition year way too literally. That's a very Irish joke. Here's a more international joke for all the visitors. If you wish to avoid getting diarrhea at your hotel, don't order the incontinental breakfast. Was I upset when I learned Muhammad Ali had passed away? apparently this group of salad extremists in the Middle East plotting to ruin every salad in the world. These goddamn balsamic fundamentalists.
Screw that joke.
I had missionary sex for the first time recently. With a priest in Africa. And apparently in Germany they have a dating app for priests. It's called Kinder. Any Christians in the room who are offended by that joke, don't take it so seriously. After all, it's not crucifact, it's crucifixion. Statistically speaking, bi-curious people are the safest of crossing the road, because they look both ways. And I'll finish tier two with some impressions. Here's one impression. Vroom, vroom. So that's a van. And vroom, vroom. That's a camper van. That's tier two. I'm going to finish with tier three, and I'll talk a bit about my dad, because tier three is where you bring in people, because maybe you're talking about stuff that's a bit sexier. And you don't offend the audience, so you talk about people you know. So I'll talk about my dad. People ask if I have father issues. No. Maybe if I ever saw the fucker. He's a good guy. When money is tight, he sells double-ended dildos. Just to make ends meet. And recently enough, I walked in on my dad masturbating. Now, I wanted to know why he didn't lock the door, but he wanted to know what I was doing walking around the house masturbating. I'm going to leave you with a piece of advice, which is this: take it home with you, take it wherever you go, and always remember that some people go numb down the left hand side of their face, and some people, they go numb down the right hand side of their face, and it makes no difference. It's like I always say, different folks. Different strokes. I'm John Kelly, thank you so much.